game is being played on February 6, 1987, between the Richland Bombers and the Pasco Bulldogs.
Thank you.
Richland 10, Pasco 8. Richland 14, Pasco 12.
Come on.
14. 4 all, 14 all. Second quarter, 18 all. 12, Pasco 20. Left 26 all. Still 439, 26 all. Pasco 28, Richland 26. Richland 28. Seven left, third quarter, 30 all.
Thank you. scored 1,000 points for Pasco High School.
Thank you.
3:36 left in the game. Pasco 40. Richland 44. Thank you. 1 second left in the game. Pasco 44, Richland 49. Congratulations, Tanya.
Seconds remaining to rally the Bulldogs to a 38-37 win over the Bombers. Take you now to Richland and third quarter action. The Bombers erased a four-point Pasco halftime lead. Jeff Breit's 21-21. Pasco was plagued by scoring drops the entire night. This lay-in by Tim Phillips was the Bulldogs' only bucket over 6.5 minutes of the third quarter. Tied now at 24, the Bombers take advantage of some poor Bulldog passing. Joe Northrup scores off the steal. Bombers on top by two. Pasco right back with yet another bad pass. This time Corey Boehning blows the lay-in, but Northrup right there to put it back. Joe at 18 points tonight. After a Pasco timeout, the Bulldogs hit four straight to tie. Going to the fourth quarter, Aaron Royko gets his perfect from the baseline, 28-28. But Pasco suffered through another scoreless spurt. Nothing through the first 5 minutes of the fourth period. Tyler Everett breaks the ice. He led all scorers with 20. From there, Richland pulled out by six. The Bombers doing it from the foul line. Pasco trailed 37-31 with 2 minutes left, but back the Bulldogs came. Royko hit two foul shots with a minute left, and Richland's lead suddenly melted to 37-36. Pasco forced Richland into critical turnovers down the stretch. Here's one of them. Northrup can't handle the pass. Pasco gets the ball back. Down by one. Pasco works the clock under 20. Then Royko gets an open jumper in the corner. It caroms off, but right to Steve Davis. He goes up from 15. He's perfect. And Richland calls timeout with 5 seconds left. Richland called the timeout, set up that play. They got the ball to Northrup, but his baseline jumper was short. Pasco 38-37, a winner. The Bulldogs 2-for-2 over the Bombers this season.
It was designed to go to Aaron Royko.
Hard by turnovers, both teams turning the ball over 12 times each in the first half. Meanwhile, Ike hit well from the outside. This one from John Ballmer as the Cadets jump out to an early 14-3 lead. Mike had chipped away. This alley-oop to Lane Shoemaker pulled the Braves to within four just before halftime. Early in the third, Kamayaka ties the score at 36 when Alec Clipper hits from the baseline. Then, moments later, the Braves steal. Shoemaker hits a driving Gary Joyner, and Kamayakin leads for the first time in the ballgame. Both teams trade buckets for the rest of the period. It's 51-50 Ike entering the final quarter. Eisenhower makes a run to go up by five, but every time John Ballmer would hit from long range, Heat Dolvin would answer with a bomb of his own. Then Lane Shoemaker put the Braves up for good with this jumper. Less than 4 minutes remain. Ike had one last chance. After a missed free throw, Chris Ellis's desperation heave at the buzzer hits the back rim. And Eisenhower loses to Kamayakin 68-67.
I don't think they can play any better. I don't think Kamayakin can play any better basketball. I know we can. And, you know, everything we told them not to do, we did, and we got ourselves in a hole.
Pasco, the Chiefs will come down to Pasco with a one-game winning streak. Moses Link gets its first conference win tonight, 49-48 over Wenatchee. Kennewick 74, Walla Walla 57, that game in Walla Walla tonight. And quickly, before we leave the Big Nine boys, let's quickly tell you how the top five spots in the conference standings shape up at this point. Richland 10-4, Eisenhower 9-4, Pasco 8-5, Kamayakin 9-5, Kennewick is 8-6. Mid-Valley boys action tonight. A big win for the Prosser Mustangs. They knocked off the Hanford Falcons in Prosser 69-63. Toppenish takes over first place in the Mid-Valley. The Wildcats upended Othello 77-46. Toppenish gets first place because Sela lost. The Vikings were defeated by West Valley tonight 69-61. Sunnyside hammered Grandview 85-70. It was Ellensburg over Eastmont 51-46. Valley A boys action, Royal knocked off Connell 53-41, and Riverview, big victory at Burbank tonight in overtime 77-75, and Colotus knocked off Touche 49-44. Big Nine girls action tonight. The Richland Bombers are red hot. The Bombers turn back Pasco tonight 49-44. Frank Tiverbaugh's ladies have now won five straight. Tanya Lamb scored 30 of Pasco's 44 points. She also went over 1,000 points for her career, although in a losing cause. The Bombers were led by Joan Spruity, who knocked down 27 points. Spruity made up for the absence of Richland's leading scorer, Wendy Frick. You see, there's Wendy Frick, number 55, limping down the floor. She only played in the first quarter tonight before leaving with an injury. Again, the Bombers over the Bulldogs.
In 85-70, they're both 9-5. Ellensburg beat Eastmont. They're now 3-11 on the season. It was Connell losing to Royal. We're now 5-2 after a 53-41 win. Riverview got its first league win in YVA East this season in an overtime game, 77-75 over the Burbank Coyotes. In girls basketball, Kamiakin continues to roll while Ike does not have a win this season. 74-46, the final up in Yakima. 9-5 are the Richland Bombers after beating Pasco 49-44. Walla Walla is 9-4 after beating Kennewick 60-49. Moses Lake moves to 7-6 after a one-point win over Wenatchee. And Connell is state bound. Most likely, they've got a 74-41 win over Royal.
Behind top place, and Pasco's at 8-5. Elsewhere, Kennewick won easily over Walla Walla High School by the score of 74-57. They moved to within two games of the top of it. The only two other scores we have tonight in the Big Nine, Wenatchee drops one to Moses Lake. That's Moses Lake's first win of the year. And Hanford dropped one to Prosser by the score of 69-63. Well, there wasn't any action in the NBA tonight because of the All-Star break. Those festivities, by the way, will get underway tomorrow in Seattle with a slam dunk contest, old-timers game, and three-point contest. Now, the game itself will be on Sunday. And speaking of that slam dunk,